everyone, it's Laura over at Hyperstamper. This was a Christmas journal that was black and red, and I got some emails requesting that I add some green to make it more Christmassy. So I'm happy to do that. Here it is. This is the cover of a 1920s, or actually earlier, school book. It's actually a science book, and I've added a stamped word Christmas here that I hand stamped and added some cardstock in green around the edges of the antique book. And it's also mounted on top of an antique book. And it has this wonderful Art Deco Bakelite knob here on brass. And that's 100 years old or more. And I added this really cool bangle that's using vintage fabrics and greens. And then some red and black ribbon and some vintage jewelry here, which is also red and green. How beautiful is that? So I'll take you on the inside. Also a little vintage earring here. That's a poinsettia. Put the cardstock on the inside as well here. And we've got a 1950s magazine page here all about winter sweaters. And that's tucked inside of a vintage children's school book with a winter scene. And I added this piece of crochet here that I just thought looked like a snowflake. I added this 1920s photograph of a child in its little winter costume, and then tucked in another 1950s Christmas family photo there from a family I don't know, but I at least somebody will get to enjoy that. And more, lots of wonderful Christmas images here from children's books. This is a vintage Christmas napkin. It's worn, but beautiful because it's old. And a 1915 Girls' Own Annual. This image here of the Christmas scene is just beautiful. And another children's image here that I've added some antique paper on the back of, polar bears that you could journal. This came from a 1940s children's book here as well. And more wonderful children's Christmas themed pages. So everything in here is authentic antique and vintage ephemera, and it's all Christmas themed. So I searched high and low in all of my books to find things that were Christmas themed, and I've been keeping them in a box over the year to make it into these wonderful Christmas journals. So you won't find many that out there that are authentic antique paper. There's lots of kits and digitals, but my style is just authentic antique because I am a great lover of antiques. So here's a full book. I was going to take it apart, but I thought that would just be wrong. So I kept it in its full booklet there and added some vintage pattern paper down here. These images are just so fun. You're gonna have so much fun going through here. There's some coupons in here from the 1940s Theater Art and Theater World magazine for subscriptions at Christmas. This is just a little vintage craft that somebody made. Some birch bark there. This came from a vintage Birds of North America book, of Birds of the Northern Forest, this one. And that is the cover of the book. From the 1920s, a banknote there, green and red. And another magazine article here for Christmas. And oh, Christmas, Christmas, Christmas is just so wonderful. Look at this beautiful little pine tree here. This is also from 1915, Girls Own Annual. Lovely, lovely berries and leaves there. It's fun to read these stories too. And more Christmas here. Wee Robin's Christmas Song. Oh, just so sweet. And this is from the 1800s, actually. It is just a book of dates, so sort of like a journal back then. And this person put in that it was their birthday, herself and Alice Judd, born in 1865 on December 5th. So I thought that was really fun for a December journal. And this wonderful full-page children's book here from the 1920s, Fairy's Christmas. And this is also from the 1800s, Sunday Reading for the Young. Look at that beautiful, beautiful image here of the birds and the Bible passage here. And some child has written in there, so I left it because I thought it was really endearing. That's some vintage graphic paper. So I hope you like it. It's going to go back up on Etsy now, and it's hyperstamper.etsy.com. Thanks.